We formed a quorum, and it's also the appointed time. Please invite the administration to come in. Good morning. Welcome, Secretary. Welcome, Chairman of the HKFA and his team. We're grateful to Mr. Ken Wu for attending the meeting this morning. We understand that you've already, or you're going to leave the FA. Thank you very much for coming this morning. Legal Advisor. Because we have a new member from their team, can you remind us of the situation under CAP 382? Thank you. Under the Electrical Power and Privileges Ordinance, CAP 3832, apart from public officers, guests attending the Electrical will not be protected by the powers and privileges enjoyed by the Council. May I draw your attention to some new papers? First is Gen 12, Staff Cost Budget for 2015-16. I understand that it is a restricted document. All right. A question for the Secretary. Now, given that this is a restricted document, what do you intend us to do? So you don't want us to read out the salaries of respective staff members, or is it just for our perusal and not for bringing up? Can you please explain the position of Gen 12, Staff Cost Budget? Thank you. Because a lot of privacy is involved. So the exact figures are for your information. Please do not read them out. All right. So please be careful when we use information in this paper. So this paper cannot be included in our report, right? Yes, this is our request. If possible, refrain from quoting from the figures here. You may refer to it with a range. And then another new paper, Gen 9, Annex C. A paper to set out what meetings have been convened. There was a previous annex, but some meetings were missing. So this is a replacement sheet. For instance, audit committee was missing from the last paper. And then, Secretary, we've got minutes missing. As of now, we have yet to receive them. Now, for those minutes, I have to defer to the FA. Regarding minutes of the board meetings, I will defer to the FA. Well, for board minutes, there are a few missing. We requested such information from you at our last meeting, but the sets of minutes are still missing. Can you please forward those minutes to us after today's meeting promptly, okay? So we are dealing with report number 74 of the Director of Audit, chapter 1. Ms. Tanya Chen and Mr. Kenneth Leung are responsible for this part. No, let me clarify first. Part 4, football development is the responsibility of Ms. Tanya Chen and also Mr. Stephen Ho. Now, for the whole of chapter or number 74, well, Ms. Tanya Chen will deal with part 4 first, because I think this is the part with more outstanding issues. So I'll give the floor to Ms. Tanya Chen first. Tanya, can you put questions to Mr. Ken Wu first, given that he is on leave? You need not worry, Chairman. I'm going to do so. At long last, we have Mr. Ken Wu with us. Welcome. Mr. Wu is the head of corporate governance of the Hong Kong FA Secretariat. Mr. Wu, can you speak closer to the microphone? I'll give you time to understand Ms. Chen's question, all right? And I'd like to confirm with you that now it was reported in the news, according to your explanation to us, you've already resigned. Is that a fact, Mr. Wu? Yes. Would you mind telling us when you submitted your resignation? Well, my contract would end on the 31st of June. So instead of resignation as completion of a contract, my contract is supposed to end on the 30th of June. I already indicated they have no intention to renew the contract. And when did you raise that point? Can you speak up? When did you choose not to renew the contract? Can you tell us the rough period? Around mid-May. Mid-May, okay. So our understanding is you're already taking your pre-resignation leave. Oh, he has already left. He's on leave. Now, today is my leave. And tomorrow is my last day. And yet, the last day, your official last day of service is the end of this month. Am I correct? Yes, correct, Chairman. Mr. Wu, when did you join? In July 2015. All right, July 2015. Did you join as the head of corporate governance, Mr. Wu? Yes. Mr. Wu, have you ever served the Secretariat of FA in the past, Mr. Wu? No. I have asked for basic information from other members of FA last time to understand your knowledge in this matter. All right, I would like to continue to ask questions about the audit committee. Gen 9. I was referring to the English version. Can we now take a look at item 9? E on page 3 of the English version. I asked Mr. Yun last time. Now, can I confirm the division of labor within the FA? According to a government paper, the FA has submitted papers to us on job description. Gen 9, NXG. With job description of various positions. Mr. Yun, have you ever verified the job description and is it still valid? Is the document still valid? Can we turn to Annex G of Gen 9? These posts are funded by government funding, first under the Project Phoenix and then under the FSIP, from the subvention was from raised from 2 million to or 20 million to $25 million dollars, and the CEO, and then the chairman, Mr. Pui, and the second post will be the position held by Mr. Ken Wu, head of corporate. Governance, I'd like to know whether you have read this job description of your position. I'd like to ask whether the job description of your position here is correct. What is your question directed to? First, to Mr. Vincent Yun, can you confirm that the information is correct regarding the job description? Under the Project Phoenix, a CEO was employed, and it is his responsibility. And I think it is through our HR and also our Organization Development Committee. I myself have not been directly involved. All right, thank you. Mr. Yun's position is not included here anyway. So, Mr. Wu, are you aware of the job description for head of corporate governance, and is it an appropriate description of your work? Mr. Wu, yes, that is roughly what I'm doing now. There are a number of areas. Financial planning is your duty, legal and compliance matter. Human resources, information technology, internal control, procurement, office administration, all-embracing. And Ms. Zhang and Mr. Zhang sitting next to you, they report to you in the main, right? Correct. All right, I'll continue. So Gen 9 is a reply from the Hong Kong FA. On the 1st of June 2020, we received this reply signed by the chairman, Mr. Pui Kwan Kei. I'd like to ask the chairman of FA whether you have read the reply and then signed, and so that you are aware of the information. Since I signed it, of course, I have read it. As for the details, well, usually documents submitted to me by my colleagues, I will read and sign. So your staff prepared the document and you signed it, right? Yes. And who prepared the paper for you? Uh, the CEO and the colleagues would have looked at the documents and passed them for me to sign. Is the CEO still a staff member? He's on leave. He's on leave. All right, I will deal with that later. All right, I'll go to item E1, page 3 of the reply. The chairman asked for minutes. According to item E1, there was reference to the minutes of the board meeting on the 6th of June 2015. It is said here that
referred in report number 74 was in fact the convener of the audit committee. There was misunderstanding because the minutes of the board meeting on the 6th of July 2105 named the appointed director of all committees as open quotation, convener stroke chairman, without any further differentiation nor elaboration.
好啊，希望可以提供啦。All right, I want the minutes to be provided. I move on to para 2. Of course, Mr. Pui gave us an explanation, but I'd like to know whether Mr. Yun would take part in board meetings. Mr. Yun, I would be present at most of the board meetings. And who provided secretariat support? Normally, I have got an assistant to listen to tape recordings of minutes of meetings and then compile the minutes. And for board meeting papers, usually I deal with them myself. And then Mr. Wu Chi Heng, according to the job description you confirmed, one of them is
board and committees. Oh, 當然啦, whenever so request 啦，咁我就想問下, 你會唔會有你有冇被曾 request 過，即係俾邀
I'd like to know whether you've ever been requested to attend all board meetings, Mr. Wu. In most of the cases, I would be present. Point 7 of key responsibility. Your position is?
And to be responsible for the drafting of papers and minutes of the meetings of both the board of directors and relevant committees. 咁其實究竟係你做啊，定係阿Jen Sack做咧？即係
So was it done by you or Jen Sack, General Secretary, Mr. Wu? I'm responsible for a few committees. I'm responsible for drafting the minutes and. As for board meetings, they're the responsibility of Mr. Yun. Well, which committees? ODC? That is the Organizational Development Committee, yes. Finance and Strategy Committee, all right. And then? Audit Committee, all right. It's fine. Take your time.
Come on.
Next, can I move on to the second paragraph? Okay, once again, I'd like to take out the audit report and refer you to page 74 of the Chinese version. There is this table 24. So, in February 2014, so of course back in 2014, Mr. Wu, you have not taken office yet. But then let's refer to table 24. It talks about the requirement to remain independent, and it says that in order to ensure that the audit committee chair would not be allowed to take up the post of other panels or other working groups chairmanship or membership. So is that description correct, Mr. Wu? Yes, correct. So how come in the letter, can I refer you to the second paragraph?
Responsible for one and two the subject. Consists of only independent chairman.
And so there is an independent chairman who is not a board member. So it doesn't mean that it's not the chairman of the board, because the chairman of the board can only take up the post of the chairmanship. But then it says here that all members of the board should not become a member. So back in 2014, so what was approved by the board, Mr. Wu? So was it that so long as he's not the chairman of the board, or he's not the chairman of other committees or subcommittees, then it's okay? Or is it that, well, all board members should not become members of the audit committee? Can you explain a bit further? So table 24. Chairman. Table 24. Well, the description here is, well, we have copied that from the terms of reference directly. And it says that, well, the chairman of the audit committee shall neither be the chairman of the board nor the chairman or member of other committees or subcommittees. So apparently, if you read that word by word, apparently that does not involve other members of the board. So that's not our interpretation. We just copy that directly from the description. So who got it wrong? Was it the audit commission or the board or what? Well, it's a decision made by the board, and then all members of the board felt that as members of the board, it's not appropriate for them to become chairman or members of the audit committee. So how was it recorded? Where could we find the records that they did say that they felt that they should not become chairman or members of the audit committee? So do you have any written records to prove that? Well, my apologies. I might not be able to get a detailed record from the minutes of meeting, because every time when we had a board meeting, well, with regard to the composition of the board, there would be a prior discussion. And then according to the board, they told us that none of them would like to become members or chairman of the audit committee, because they themselves felt that it would not be appropriate for them to become chairman or members of the audit committee. Okay, chairman. I think with regard to the right to know and also to be fair to all of them, with regard to the 2014 minutes of meeting of the relevant board, I think it's better to give us a copy of those. Yes, we are aware of that. We are making preparation for that. We have to have the direction of the board before we can do it. If you're not able to do it, well, then we can ask for instructions from the board here. So please circulate that. So is it that you will have to wait until there is a board meeting? No, we can do that by circulation. Okay, can I move on to a later part? So that's page 5 of the reply. My apologies, Mr. Kenneth Leung. So the answer is, so it's already item E, Roman 2. So that's at the top of the of page 5. And according to the description on the next page, it says that after the setting up of the audit committee, from March 2014 to March 2015, a total of 5 meetings were held by the audit committee. Have I got it right, Mr. Wu? So which period are you referring to? Because in your table, that's on page 4 of the English version, And according to the table, so on the 7th of February 2014, the board approved the establishment of the audit committee. And then after that, five meetings were held. So that was in May, August, May 2014, August 2014, January 2015, and March 2015. So altogether, four meetings were held. Have I got it right? Yes. Chairman, well, for the audit committee's meetings, well, that was on the 9th of April 2014, and also the 3rd of July 2014, and then, altogether, four meetings. So that was in column two. So April 9th, or July 3rd, November 11th, and February 13th. Okay. So Mr. Ken Wu, seated next to you, should be one of the members. So he's a member of the audit committee. Well, I wasn't a member throughout the period. So it was only... until November 2014 that I joined the audit committee. Okay, thank you. So you did join the audit committee that was still in existence, right? So you did participate in the meeting of the audit committee, right, Mr. Wu? Yes, correct. So you should be vaguely aware of what the audit committee was doing, right? Yes. Okay, I'll be following up on that later. I'd like to first clarify the answer. And then moving on. Because that paragraph said that the HKFA secretariat did draw the attention of the board to that no successful appointments. So
that means the audit committee was failed to form in the terms of 2015 to 2017 and 2017 to 2019. 咁請問呢一段係邊一個嘅 knowledge 咧？即係邊一個？
So, who can confirm that indeed the secretariat did make an attempt to give an explanation to the board as to why the audit committee could not be set up? So, who can confirm that? Mr. Wu, can you answer the question? So that's the answer on page 5, English version, the first paragraph. Can you give him some time to read it? Chairman, can I answer the question? Well, on that particular point as to how the secretariat did draw the attention to the board that no successful appointments had been made to the audit committee. In fact, if my memory serves me right, every time when we tried to set up the audit committee, we would not be able to have all the members ready. So at the start, we would try to appoint different directors, and then they would spend time to identify the right candidates, and then they would go back to the board for verification or endorsement. If I remember it correctly, in the term 2015 to 2017, individual members took up to 6 to 9 months before they can be set up. And I remember there was one newly set up members committee because it's a new committee, and then by October there wasn't this full list of candidates, and then the audit committee, I also brought that up, that was it wasn't set up yet. And then on the other occasion, if I remember it, that was in 2017 when there was a new term, and then when we tried to appoint the new members, and then when we took out the list, we also reminded the board that in fact the audit committee still had not got any candidates yet. So I remember that was those were the two occasions when I brought it up to the board's attention. So it's not that there wasn't this convener. So you had the convener. So you had the convener of the audit committee, but then it's that you failed to get sufficient members to join the audit committee, right? Yes, correct. So did you draw the attention of the board at formal board meetings, or did you bring it up at informal occasions. So were there minutes to verify that? Well, I can identify the minutes. I can try to find the minutes. Because it's just a soft reminder. So it's a soft reminder. Well, Chairman, are you aware of that or not? Because supposedly the reminder was for the board. I think what Mr. Yun just said was right. So there was a soft reminder. Maybe he did that, but then by the time when it was recorded in the minutes, I couldn't remember exactly because Mr. Hoi was still the convener and he was trying to help the members. And of course, there might have been some personal reasons or other factors. So he did attend the board meeting, but then it wasn't clear about how things were going. Okay, you call him the convener, but then according to the audit report, he was also the chairman of the audit committee, and he was also the ODC, that's Organization Development Committee's chairman. So he was wearing two hats at the same time. And one of the committees didn't even have any members. So I hope that you can also provide us with the minutes of the meeting to prove that. So I'm not going to dwell on it. So Mr. Hui thought that he could take up the chairmanship of both committees. Is that right? Well, I'd like to clarify because Mr. Hui was the chairman of the ODC, so one of the two committees, and he was kind enough to be willing to take up the chairmanship of the audit committee as well. So that's your description. Okay, I'll be following up on that, and you understand why. I still think that the convener was Mr. Hui. Okay, I'll be coming to that shortly. Okay, next, about the answer. Item E3. So first is about the annual report, as we all remember. Because at two meetings earlier, when we were looking at, well, let me get the pile here. Which bundle? Okay, these are the annual reports. So I had 2013-14, 2014-15, 2015-16, 2016-17, and then 2017-18. And then last time we found out one statement here, and that statement was that the HKFA's accounts after it's been confirmed by the audit, the finance committee and the audit committee. Well, but then in 2015, 2016, 2017, 2017-18, you had the same statement, but then there was no meeting convened. So that's the reason why we questioned that, and we then asked things about the annual report, and then we were told that annual report was a publicity material. Okay, publicity material prepared for the consumption of HKMA voting and non-voting members only.
Made available publicly on HKFA's website to interested persons.
So, Mr. Pui, is that your understanding? So, the annual report is just a publicity material. I'll defer to Mr. Yu to answer the question on my behalf. Well, Chairman, the reply that we gave them, well, please note that, well, for our annual report, the main purpose was to provide to our members so that they would be aware of our working report every year. So that's the type of document that we provide to our members. But then it's a different thing when you describe it as a publicity material. Can you explain that to us? Why are you describing it as a publicity material? What's the purpose? Why have you done so? Because the annual report is a very important document. And you call it publicity material. Can you explain that? Or is it that you might not have used the right word? So I'm giving you the chance to explain. So how did you put it in Chinese? Well, that's again a translation. So it says that it's a translation, and according to the way they put it, E3. So it's a 宣傳刊物, publicity material. Well, because when the CEO prepared that, of course, he did it in English. Well, you will have to be very careful about the choice of words. Yes, I understand that the annual report does have the Chinese and English versions. Do I have to read that out to you? Well, your annual reports would also have to be submitted to the administration. Well, the administration said that they had never received any annual report from the HKFA, right? But then the budget would have to be passed on to you because you will have to pay. Is that right, Commissioner? Well, under the FYSP, the HKFA submitted a report to us annually, but then that is not the same thing as the annual report that they prepare. It's an entirely different thing. Okay, so Mr. Yun, well, of course, I can see that you'd be more careful in the future, right? But then I'd like to address this to Mr. Wu, because just now we were referring to a very special statement which could be described as totally incorrect, and in which part of the annual report did appear? So that's corporate governance statement. So it appears in the corporate governance statement. So Mr. Wu, when you publish that corporate governance statement, would you have a chance to scrutinize it? Yes. So given the fact that you had been sitting on the audit committee before you joined the HKFA, and then after joining it, you were also the head of corporate governance, and you were supposed to provide secretariat. Services to the audit committee, or the preparation of minutes and so on and so forth. So I'd like to know, well, internal control and risk management, so accounts and audit. So given the fact that that statement was there for so many years, given the fact that you never formed the audit committee and there was no meeting whatsoever, so would that statement be problematic then, Mr. Wolf? Well, looking back, it's an incorrect description. What's your explanation? So we don't need you to say that it's incorrect. Okay, you now know that it's incorrect, but then what was your feeling then? Back then, how did you feel about this? What's your reply? Is it that there was external auditor helping you to scrutinize the audits? That's why you would have felt that it's the same as having the audit committee done its job. So which accountancy firm did you engage to do the auditing work? Well, we did have an external auditing company to do the audit report for us. So did your external auditing firm have to go through the board? Yes, indeed. It has to be approved by our board. It also has to be approved by the AGM. So Ms. Chen was asking you, so you didn't have any meeting at all, and then you suppose there were meetings and they already scrutinized the audits. So the English version was that the accounts of the HKFA was endorsed by the Finance Subcommittee and Audit Committee, and subsequently High Court.
即使你了解到這句是說什麼,是不是?那你是,你是一個...
Can you give us an explanation? So you are the head, as head of corporate governance, you don't think that there is some problem to it and you need to check the accounts. Chairman, well, we do this annually, and basically we would look at it from the angle of the corporate governance, and the contents may not be very detailed because it is only a very brief summary. And of course, looking back, we know that it's not as accurate. Well, this is your responsibility. You took up this position as head of corporate governance. Corporate governance means to tell the truth, to report the truth, and to execute governance work. Isn't that under your terms of reference? Ms. Tanya Chen asked you this question before, and you replied in the affirmative. Yes, Chairman. That means you didn't notice that the report is a publicity material, and second, this is an inaccurate publicity material. And you didn't look through the publicity material. Did you look through the publicity material? Well, I did read the draft, but you didn't find any problems with it. Did you identify any problems? I didn't identify any problems. Well, did you see some differences each year on your corporate governance statement? Every year, those two pages, whether it be the English or Chinese, there have been some changes made. It's not exactly copy and paste. Do you realize that? Well, can you tell us the differences? Yes, even within the committees. Because first, you see principles, and secondly, composition and appointment of the board. And third, responsibilities of the board. Fourth, committees. Five, internal control and risk management. And then accounts and audits. And then staff remuneration. And then declaration of interest. Well, there may be slight differences each year to that. Do you know that? Well, I did notice that there were some changes made to the figures. Figures? I'm talking about the year and then the number of meetings. Well, yes, yeah, so you only copy and paste, and then you just change the date 2013 to 14 to 2014 to 14. But actually, there are changes made to the formation. I'm holding in my hand the report 2014 to 2015. There's in. And then you can see that there is an electoral committee. And then in 2015 and 2016, this committee disappeared. How can you overlook these matters? We're talking about very important accounts here. Mr. Wu? I just want to know why. Well, I guess I wasn't too thorough in going through the papers. I was one of many who read through because this has been circulated amongst the staff and also the board to have it approved. The board has a responsibility. When the chairman signs on a report, he needs to be diligent in what was read. I understand that the chairman has to sign many documents each day. Therefore, you should actually review it carefully before you submit it for approval by the chairman. We want to know whether you are using public funding wisely. You were receiving over 1 million in salary each year, yet you are not very conscientious. We are spending time to go through all the details. We're not trying to be nitpicking here. We just want to make sure that public money is being spent well. And each year, when you go look through the rainbow funding, you need to understand what your duties are. The board believes in you, and the chairman signs the reports. And you haven't executed your functions or performed your duties. And this is a very serious allegation. Do you understand that, Mr. Wu? And Mr. Yun, do you understand that as well? It's a pity that the CEO is not here. The chairman bears the responsibility because you are the one who's signing the papers. You have your signature next to it. So, chairman, you really should look through them carefully before you sign the papers. Well, I'm the chairman of many boards, and well, I'm just a volunteer. I try my best, but I do. So I mostly rely on the CEO. Well, last week we held a board meeting from 3 p.m. to 9 p.m. We didn't even have time for a snack or anything. Well, you took up this challenge, and therefore you will need to work for it. Well, you learn like us, you know, when we hold meetings here, we hold them from morning till night. Well, not only you, we also need to read our papers overnight too. Well, Mr. Pui, yes, we understand that you're not salaried. Therefore, those who are being paid for their jobs and being paid by government money should really execute their functions. We're not asking for anything unreasonable. I'm not even talking about how well you're doing it. It's just that you haven't even done it at all. Well, I'm almost done with the audit committee, but then I have a question for another committee. I'd like to ask Mr. Cheng, as the internal control manager, you also have your own job description, which is after Mr. Wu's. Your job is actually quite challenging. Your post number 8, which is on page 7. No. Is it post number 7 on the government paper? No, this is the internal control manager. It's post number 8. I'm talking about job description in the annex. I'm sorry, I am still on Gen 12. I see that one of your key responsibilities is to provide secretarial support for governance-related committees, that is the audit committee. Do you know that the audit committee has not yet been formed, Mr. Cheng? Yes, I know that. So, what did you do? Did you notify your superior, Mr. Wu? Yes, I did. Well, what was his response, Mr. Cheng? So Mr. Cheng's superior is Mr. Wu, am I correct? Yes, so you did relay this information to Mr. Wu. Yes, I did. And what did Mr. Wu say? Well, he also reported to his superior, as I understand. All right, Mr. Wu, so who did you report to? I reported it to the CEO. Well, there are two CEOs. One has already left his position, and the other has also left. I'm sorry, Chairman. Well, the one who left his position earlier, or was that whom you told? I'm talking about the former CEO here. Well, if I remember correctly, the one who just left actually came on board in 2019. Mr. Yin, do you know whether the former CEO took any action? Well, when I reported it to him, Chairman, my understanding was that he would report it to the board. Well, although the audit committee was not yet formed that time, do you know whether there was a convener or a chairman? Mr. Wu, my understanding was that there was a convener. All right, thank you. Next item. Who was the convener then, Mr. Hui? Yes. Well, you know that there is a convener, and Mr. Yun last week showed us the terms of reference of the committee members. I would like to 12. Well, I know that you take some time on audit committee terms of reference, which is page 99. And last Friday, we confirmed with Mr. Yun that the there is a ACP 1920-002 paper, which came into effect in 2014. Then to page 3. Well, you talked about note 2 last week.
Or chairman directly wherever needed. On the other hand, without jeopardizing the independence of the audit committee, the chairman of finance and strategy committee shall play the role as the convener. This convener 应该是 audit committee 的 convener 啦，系咪？ To assist in bridging the communication of management information between the audit committee and the board as appropriate. This convener is what convener?
So who's the convener here? I assume it's the audit committee convener. Who would like to explain that? Mr. Yun, my understanding is that, well, don't tell us your understanding. Let us ask them to explain. Well, maybe it may be very difficult to understand. Mr. Yun, would you like to take this question? U.S. Company Secretary, can you tell us your understanding on this convener? The convener here refers to the audit committee convener, the board member. So the chairman of finance and strategy committee will be the ex officio member of the audit committee, and he acts as the convener. Am I correct? When the audit committee submits a term of reference, the board agrees that the finance and strategy committee chairman shall play the role as the convener of the audit committee. So from 2015 to 2019, was there any Finance and Strategy Committee? Yes. Who was the chairman? Mr. Sin Yapkin. So from 2015-2017, it was Mr. Sin Yapkin. From 2017 to 2019, it was another person. Yes, it was Mr. Hong Bo-Bin. Well, since you stated here that the convener should be the chairman of Finance and Strategy Committee, then how come you told us that today Mr. Samuel Hui is the convener of Audit Committee? So Mr. Sin Yat-Kin or Mr. Hong Bo-Ga should be the convener. How come Mr. Hui is the convener? Well, in 2015, when we started to form the committee, we followed these terms of reference. But then, as I remember, when the board set up to form new committees, they chose Mr. Samuel Hui as the convener. The board also has the authority to appoint conveners. Chairman, I really don't understand what he is talking about here. You have a clear note here, which you don't follow. In 2014, my understanding is that the Audit Committee convener was the chairman of Finance and Strategy Committee, who was Mr. Ngin. Am I correct? So how come in 2015, starting from 2015, it all became so confusing? Well, I cannot explain on behalf of the board. Well, it's under their capacity to amend the terms. Well, yes, I did confirm with them that this paper has been used since 2014 till now. Mr. Yun, do you remember that? Do you have a minutes on when the amendments were made? It's all right if you amend it. Or there were new board members coming up in that new term. Mr. Wu, you are in charge of good corporate governance. So when the board made changes to the regulations, you have the responsibility to remind the board. Or in particular, governance issues are under your ambit. You can't just disregard these matters. A chairman, when I haven't taken up position when they made the changes. Well, how about in 2017? When did you join? I joined in July 2015. How about the second term from 2017 to 2019? Were you there as well?
And Mr. Martin Hui is the head of the Finance and Strategy Committee. Shouldn't he be the convener of the Audit Committee? Allow me to supplement. Chairman, perhaps when it comes to the Division of Labor, Mr. Martin Hong felt that he didn't want to be the convener of the Audit Committee as well. And so at board meetings, we had a Division of Labor and then came to a conclusion. They discussed who should be the chairman or convener of a particular committee or subcommittee. perhaps Mr. Hong thought that he wanted to concentrate in his post as Finance and Strategy Committee. So perhaps never sat on any committees because since the Project Phoenix, I have been on the board for more than 10 years, and I felt that would be better for young new blood to be chairman of committees to promote the development of football. Chairman, because what you did was not in compliance of the rules, so we have to find out the reasons. And we would like to ask you to search your memory to find out the reasons so that we will not have a repeat of such things. So all our reports are forward-looking. Still, we have to find out what were the mistakes in the past. Otherwise, we won't be able to come up with a report on how to reform the organization. Yes, I agree with you. Whether it be the new board and various staff in the governing body. Well, because FA is tasked to promote football among our young people and develop football as a sport. But if you do not implement the policies well, then as a result, we cannot develop football in Hong Kong. And the FA has not discharged its duties. We've spent so much time to help you to find out the reasons. Now, we are not finding faults, but I hope you understand. We know that you all serve on a pro bono basis. But then the government has funded you to hire well-paid executives. And as a result, the association gave us sent out wrong messages, and then they were not found out. So we might be deceived, and therefore we are trying to work with you to find out. Yes, I said that the Audit Commission gave us a major health check. Well, last week you met for so many hours without taking a sandwich. Now, because you're finding out the information, how come you made so many mistakes, and we are trying to help? Yes, correct. We should find out the mistakes and then tackle the problems. Ms. Tanya Chen, I think the former chairman and the former CEO have a big responsibility. I think the new term would like to do a better job because of the audit report. We have to find out the inadequacies because FA has almost the longest history and established association in Hong Kong. And I hope you don't mind. We want governance to be better in future. Corporate governance can improve in the future. And we have found some problems. We want to deal with them. And then you can set a good example for other NSAs. All right, I'll continue to ask about the Finance and Strategy Committee. To give the background of the F&S Committee, according to the Articles 29.1 of Hong Kong FA, it is a standing committee, and there are six other committees. Organization and Development Committee is also one of the six. Its function or standing committees have to advise and assess the board in the discharge of its duties. As I said, the F&S Committee is a standing committee. FSC's main, the quorum is three. And according to your Articles of Association and Article 41, I am sorry, I haven't prepared a copy for you. I'll read it out simply for you.
Independent auditors. 那个英文呢就是 auditors shall be appointed by the assembly at the AGM and shall audit the accounts approved by the finance and strategy committee in accordance with the appropriate principles of accounting and present a report to the assembly. The auditors shall be appointed for one financial period and this mandate may be renewed. 这个就是说,这些 accounts 是要 approved by finance and strategy committee.
Accounts have to be approved by the FSG. Can someone confirm what I read out was correct? Mr. Yun, yes. Our audited accounts were considered by the FSC, Finance and Strategy Committee. According to the AA, it should be the FSC. I'd like to know whether the board has ever approved giving the or delegating the approval of audited committees to audited accounts to its finance subcommittee. Regarding the FSC, when it was first established, the board felt that finance and strategy are two different areas of work. So the chairman of the then FSD recommended that the committee be split into two subcommittees, one responsible for finance and other responsible for strategy. When was the time? In 2011. Well, I just read out the AA in 2015. According to that article, the FSG was responsible for approving the audited accounts, and you told us that the arrangement started in 2011. Yes, for the same paragraph in the 2015 version of the AA, it had two more standing committees compared with the 2011 version. So for every term, the committees are constituted according to the same model. And why? What about the difference between 2011 and 2015? Well, there has never been any change in the division of labor within the Finance and Strategy Committee. All right. Now, I understand that you can vary the article 24.5.
Nominated by the board to serve as honorary treasurer and shall chair the Finance and Strategy Committee. 那我想问一下,
So I'd like to know who was the honorary treasurer in between 2015 and 2019. Mr. Sin Yakin. Who? Mr. Sin Yakin was the chairman of Finance and Strategy Committee, so he was also the honorary treasurer. And of course, in 2017, Mr. Martin Hong was the chairman of Finance and Strategy Committee, so he became the honorary treasurer. Was it shown in the organization chart? Honorary vice president, but not honorary treasurer. We can't find it on your websites. How can we No. In our list of board directors, there is a remark there to show who's the treasury, who is the honorary treasurer. So the honorary treasurer should be chairman of the Finance and Strategy Committee by default, right? Tanya, so the convener acts as a communication between the Audit Committee, Management and Finance and Strategy Committee. So the chairman of FST is the convener of the Audit Committee, not the chairman. I'd like to know whether we have a new Annex C. I don't have it. Oh, it's already included in the bundle. Give me 2 seconds. No, I've got it already. In your replacement sheet of Annex C, when the CEO was here, Mr. Kenneth Leung requested this table. FSC on page 1, it did meet in 2014 and 2015, yes. Over the page, 2015 to 2016, it never met. 2016 to 2017, it never met. 2017 to 2018, no meeting. 2018 to 19, no meeting. 2019 to 20, wow, it's even more outrageous. It is no longer here. Do you have to update your table once again? So is it that the FSC has become two, Finance Subcommittee and Strategy Subcommittee, right?
You know, lady.
You have to explain. You have to explain. Now, if it started in 2011, despite your change of the AA, now, the audited accounts must be approved by the SFC. But in 2014, there were meetings for both the committee and the subcommittees. And then after 2015, the AA was amended. And then, starting from then to 2019, there have never been meetings. I really beg you to give us an explanation. All right, the subcommittees did meet, and Ms. Chen said that starting from 2015, or from 2015 onwards, there has never been any meeting of FSC. And from July 2019 to now, it has entirely disappeared. So they have left it out even in their copy and paste exercise. Instead, you had subcommittee meetings. In 2011, the committee was set up. And then it had to deal with finance and strategy, two very different areas. The chairman, the then chairman of FSC, split the committee into two subcommittees. So on the same day, the two subcommittees would meet one after another. Well, for instance, in the strange subcommittee, there is a doctor specializing in sports science. However, We didn't want to bother him with finance matters. So that's why they've had two subcommittees. If you look at the information, you can see that the finance subcommittee and strategy subcommittees always met on the same day. You have to explain when they had met. Please refer to the document. Now, if you take a look at 2014 to 15, FSC met for four times. On the contrary, the subcommittees did not appear on this. So what is Mr. Yun talking about? That's why I'm asking him to explain. Do you know what you're talking about, Mr. Yun? At different times, the committee may meet as a committee, but may split a meeting into two. Then can you please explain? From 2015 onwards, or from 2017 onwards, FSC never appears. All right, Mr. Ken Wu, head of corporate governance, are you of the opinion that it has complied with the Articles of Association? Don't forget that when the AA first appeared, the 2nd of March 2015, in May 2015, there were still meetings of the FSC. You have to understand that you want to amend your AA, you have to inform and get the approval of the HAB first. So the board can just amend the AA and change their organization. Can you please go back and check this first? Because you failed to explain how come they appear and disappeared all of a sudden. And how come there were never meetings of FSC? If you're not too clear, do you want us to go through the paper with you? All right, then please continue. Chairman, I have no further questions. Mr. Wu, do you have any further thing to say for this part? I have nothing more to add for the time being. I think this part has brought out a lot of issues. You altered the structure. You amended the AA. If you know the reasons for these, do find out the information for us. You cannot just say that you forgot to do it or you didn't know why this cannot. It's unacceptable. One more question. Going back to the reply in Gen 9, page 6. I'd like to confirm, because once again, I saw a typo. In 2019, a new audit committee had been formed. The annual
2019 had been endorsed by the audit committee in February 2019. 2020年 financial statement.
Are you actually talking about February 2020? Because if the annual audited financial statements were those for 2018-19, and the end of financial year should be the 30th of June, so it was impossible for the audit committee to endorse it in February 2019. So can I confirm? Should it really be 2020? Should I put a question to Mr. Yun or Mr. Wu? Mr. Wu hasn't resigned yet, right?
Yes, sir. It's a typo. It should have been February 2020. So you have to be really very careful about your documentation. So, Chairman, you'll have to sign it all over again. Okay, Chairman, I'll wait till later before I ask further questions. Yes, sir. Can we have a break of 10 minutes? Okay, a break of 10 minutes. So let's take a break of 10 minutes. Director of Audit.